here's my form for what I'm going to cast next, and there's the backboard I got right there. I've already put talcum powder as a release agent. I forgot to film. I was going to go ahead and film that as well. But I don't put it on. I don't want to put it on real thick. But it doesn't build up in the corners there. Got a good fine coat on the form itself. That way it should release from my sand when I've got it all hardened up. Okay. Next thing to do is put the drag on. It's going to take both hands, so I'm going to set this down for a minute while I do that. Now I've got it set in the drag. Give myself a couple inches, inch and a half or so all the way around. Now what you see here for my form, these are called core pockets. The aluminum won't come this far if everything works the way it's supposed to. That's the core pocket. This is the edge of the actual casting right here. I've got a core that I made. I tried to videotape that, but it didn't work out too well, so. We'll see how that, maybe next time I'll get a shot of it. And it'll fit inside these pockets, so therefore the casting will be hollow when it's all done. Next thing to do is mix up the sand and sodium silicate that I made up, and then create my mold with it. So that's the next thing. I'll be doing that in this big old bottom of this barrel. Sifted already. Now, if this was an industrial strength, commercial type stuff, I probably could measure it out, be relatively confident in its strength, but since I made it myself, I just gotta go by feel. I go until I feel like everything is wet, and then add a little bit more. Obviously, it's going to take a lot more than that. Pretty good. I used to like to grab it like so. If it stays clumped, it stays like that. Almost like green sand when you do that. I feel like that might be enough. Clumps them here as I roll them out and create more, so I think I've got more than adequate.
o'clock, so.
All right, here we are. Oh, 20 minutes, maybe 30 minutes later. Sand is packed. I got it squared off for the bottom part. Next step will be to expose it to carbon dioxide. What I do for that, I take a screwdriver and put a series of holes down through the thing. Don't want to get them too close or you'll blow carbon dioxide out the hole neighboring it. I like to go all the way around. Then of course there's going to be a spot here or there where it's going to want to touch the actual form itself. And about right there. Get on each side of it if I can. About right here. About right there. This will go right into the... This is going right into the form. I can feel the form right there, see? I got them separated, spaced out pretty good. You know, hurt, yeah, we'll see what happens here. Anyway, got carbon dioxide, plenty of it.
What I can do is set the tubing down inside there first, feed it best I can. Buy some gas, all 10, 15 pounds. I can feel it coming out around there. Just slowly bring it out.
Thing to carbon dioxide, and I went ahead and filled the holes. You can see I'm pushing pretty hard. And it's not doing anything to that sand. It's rock hard. Now I'll just put a bottom on it and flip it over. There it is, flipped over. You can see the form is still inside. I'll place the other half of the form on that. Put the cope on top. Release agent all around, pack the coke, harden it with the carbon dioxide just like I did the drag. Then I'll take them apart, remove
the form removed.
I pulled it out last night before I left. It's been sitting here air drying ever since. Next step, I'll clean out all the extra crumbs that you can see in here. Put the form back in it. Okay, so now I've got the form back in its place, and I've dug out the sprue and end gate, so that's where the aluminum will go in when it's cast. Next thing of then, now is the next thing, is put the rest of the form in, and with the sprue and a couple of vents, and built the coke. So, let's go ahead and get the other half of the form. How it goes here. A1 is over there. I'm going to set this down. This is a two-handed operation here. Now you can see how that goes on there. The next thing is put the coke frame for the coke on. And then start packing sand again with the vents and the sprue. I'll use this to build the sprue right there. And I'll need to fill in for that. I should have done that after building the coat. Oh well. I'll figure out what to do there. Put the talc powder to release, well, to help release the two, the cope and the drag from each other, and hopefully remove the form. There's going to be the sprue, of course, that'll be removed, and it'll just be a hole in the sand. I went ahead and filled the trench in with loose sand, so that'll be easier to clean out. And hopefully that'll mark the area in the cope where I can remove some of that. That'll give me a good large flow ingate. And then I'll put my vents right on top of the form as I build it. Alright, finished product. I'll do a little cleanup once I part it and pull the forms out. And dress it up a little bit probably. Clean any crumbs that I got from the sand. All the little vents I'm going to leave there. That's where I put in the carbon dioxide to harden the sodium silicate. But they should provide good vintage when that hot aluminum hits it, it'll want to gas off, so that'll provide some good venting. I got two large vents for the aluminum. Those are called risers in some cases. Some people call them risers. And then, of course, there's my sprue, a little pour cup built up around it. And next task, like I said, take the cope off the drag, remove the forms, clean it up, and then put that core in. Put it all back together and get ready to pour. I'd let it solidify for about a week before I try to pour it. Okay, here's the cope. Now, when I did the drag before I built the cope, I went ahead and did the ingate at the sprue. Then I had to fill it in, that right there, the ingate right there. Filled it in with loose sand. So that when I built the cope on it, it actually left an impression about the outline of that. So it left me the ability to go ahead and carve out a little bit more of the ingate into the cope itself. So maybe that'll give me a little bit better flow. I'll clean this up a little bit better. It's a little bit soft. I can smooth it out some, but stuff is like rock. That's awesome stuff. When I pulled the form out, I cracked it a little bit. A little Elmer's wood glue and glued it back in place. That'll hold surprisingly enough for what it's going to be, seeing as how it's at the end of the pocket there, the core pocket. It's really not going to make any effect on the casting. Now over here, I had some crackage going on. When I pulled my form up, I didn't have it cleared off the edge good enough, and I popped the edge and kind of caused it to crack. So what I did is I glued it back in place as well. We went back and sealed the crack with some more of that sand and inhaled the carbon dioxide and solidified. It'll do okay. It's only going to be this much, and the worst thing that'll happen is I'll get some flashing I can grind off the final casting. But anyway, you can see where my vents are going to be there. Now it's just a matter of installing the core and putting it all back together. Melting some aluminum and pouring it in there. This will be the drag. I'm going to do some patchwork on my lettering. I want it to show up in the casting. So, there we go. And my coat sitting over here waiting. I got to install that in the drag. And when I do, it'll look like a coat over here. Installed in the coat. Two halves will meet together and you'll have that big hollow area.